Last week I explained polytropic boundary work. The polytropic process is here. Pressure is equal to C volume power of minus N. C and N is constant. N is polytropic exponent. For boundary work, as you know, that boundary work is from 1 to 2. The compression or the expansion is not important. P, pressure, and differential volume. And as you know, that P is here. P is C volume power of minus N. After that, we write that 1 to 2. This is, as you see, is P. Therefore, C is constant and N is also constant. For constant, we extract from the integral C and volume minus. I mean that we extract the C from here and we make the integral of volume power of minus n dv, d volume. Therefore, C is constant, volume power of minus n plus 1 divided by n plus 1 from 1 to 2. After that, we write the explicitly here. From first, we write 2 state 2 minus state 1, as you see here. Mm-hmm. And in this situation, C is and if we make here, C is pressure and volume times power N, and we multiply the pressure, volume times power N, and multiply this one. After that, P is C minus, or we can say the C is, if the C is constant, okay, P1 pressure 1 and volume 1 times power N is equal to P2 volume 2 times power N is equal. Yeah. Okay, because C is that equation that I don't understand. Hey guys, you speak each other, but I don't understand. And C is constant. And in this situation, I multiply to P2 and for multiplying this term. Okay, after that, our boundary work is pressure to volume 2 minus pressure 1 volume 1 divided by 1 minus N. Okay. I calculate the explicitly because last week I didn't do, I explained, but I want to explain with detail in polytropic process and boundary work. Okay, boundary work is here. I mean that I, of course, I opened the record. It's good. Now, this is the example 4-5. Okay, it's also a good example because a lot of formulation insight in it. I mean that after that I will explain later. A piston cylinder device contains 25 kilogram of saturated vapor. Water vapor that is maintained at a constant pressure of 300 kilopascal. I mean that they said that this is saturation, water vapor, state one, and it has 25 gram, and with constant pressure, 300 kilopascal. And a resistance heater within the cylinder is turned on and the pressure passes a current of 0.2 ampere for 5 minutes from a 120 volt force. Okay, the electrical work come here. At the same time, at the heat loss of 3.7 kilojoule occurs. Okay. At the same time, heat is a resistance heater is working. At the same time, Q is outing from the system. And shows that for a closed system, two boundary work WB and changing of the internal energy delta U in the first half of the relation can be combined into the one term. And delta H for a constant pressure process. Okay, it means that they said that what is the boundary work and you define the first half relation of the thermodynamics. And for B, determine the final temperature of the steam. Okay, they said that what is the final temperature. And we looked at this for the boundary work. The boundary work is come here. For example, induced station volume is increasing, therefore pressure is constant. Therefore, we said that from state one to state two like this because pressure is constant. Also, they said that for a constant pressure, they of course said that for a constant pressure. Okay. Because of this, because of the constant pressure, our state one is the saturated vapor and the other one for the constant pressure. Therefore, our state two is superheated region. Okay. Now, we are going to solve this. For closed system, first of all, they said that this is important. Show that the relation for the closed system boundary work, WB and change in the internal energy in the first half of relation. Okay, we write the first law of thermodynamics. What about the first law of thermodynamics? Okay, there are the first law of relation, first law of thermodynamic relation. Inlet energy minus outlet energy is equal to energy changing. Okay, delta energy system. After that, the closed system thermodynamics first law is Q minus W is equal to delta U. In this situation, our problem is stationary. Our system is not working. There is no velocity. Our system has no velocity. Therefore, kinetic energy and potential energy is going zero. And Q, W, other means maybe electrical work. You see here after that boundary work and work is W other and it contains W other and the boundary works is equal to U2 minus U1, delta U changing. Okay. They said that constant pressure process. This is important here. Okay. Q, W minus W other, because this is the, we found the first law of thermodynamics. This is the general form, the writing of the general form. Okay. General form of, first law of thermodynamics for closed system. Okay. For closed system, general form. After that, what about the boundary work for constant pressure? Pressure is constant, P0, for example, and second state of volume minus first state of volume. Okay. After that, pressure is constant, therefore P0 is equal to P2 is equal to P1. And we write the Q minus work is equal to U2 plus P2 volume 2 minus U1 plus P1 minus 1, as you see here with my mouse. Okay, because P0 is equal to P2 is equal to P1, therefore we make the plus here, U2 plus P2 pressure to volume 2 minus U1 plus pressure 1 and minus 1. And I am going to ask one question. What is this term? You know this term.
Enthalpy.
Enthalpy. Enthalpy is true. Therefore, H is enthalpy is the internal energy and the boundary work. And in this situation, Q, this is the general form of the first of thermodynamics, Q minus W other work is equal to, therefore, H2 enthalpy to second state of enthalpy minus first state of enthalpy. Okay. They said that you find the first of relation can be combined in a one term delta H. Therefore, we use this form. Also, we can write here Q minus W other is equal to delta H, okay, the enthalpy changing. And what about the U? This is the first we have, they asked the, what is the change of internal energy, they ask, okay. Also the problem ask us. And in this situation, W other is electrical work, as you know that. And what about the electrical work? For electrical work, this is the volt. This looks like volume, but this is the volt, okay. Volt, ampere, the currency is, and after multiple delta T, it is kilojoule, okay. As you know that volt and ampere is the of this watt, but if we define the, if we multiply the time, also this is the watt, this is units, so okay. After that we multiply the delta T or T, this is the joule, okay. Joule or kilojoule is not important, kilowatt or kilojoule. And we said that 120 volt, 0.2 ampere, and this is the 5 minute. 5 minute is the 30 second. And if we divide it 1000, because of the, we calculate the kilopascal, in the situation, electrical work is 7.2 kilojoule. Okay. Now we calculate the electrical work, I mean other works. Now, we said that, also our problem is like this, because they said that what is the internal energy changing? First of all, we calculate the state one, saturated vapor at constant pressure. After that, with the, again, the constant pressure, saturated vapor, okay. And after this situation, we calculate the internal energy changing. After that, what is the final temperature of the steam? There are also said that this is the steam. Steam is the vapor, as you know that. Again, we look to table. Okay, for state one, we look to table. And I am open the table here. Saturated water, but pressure table we looked, because the problem gives us a pressure. Okay. Table A5. What about the pressure is 300, as far as I remember, look, yeah, 300 kilopascal. For the 300 kilopascal, what we look here, maybe we can look H, because of the, our problem is turned to Q and W other is equal to H2 minus H1. Okay, first we look H, what is the H column is? This is the saturation vapor here, Hg, and 300 kilopascal. It is the first H is first state of H is 2724.9 kilojoule divided by kilogram. We looked here from the table. Okay. H1 is the for the first state, H is the saturated vapor at 300 kilopascal because problem is given for 300 kilopascal. And therefore, we find the first H. Therefore, we know that this one. Okay. First H is this one. And after that, we know. Now we write the first law of thermodynamics. Okay. Our problems, what is our problem? Maybe I should like this because of the understanding the problem. I put the figure here. Maybe this is a small one, but it is not important. Okay. In the situation, electrical in, because this is the not general form of the first of thermodynamics. This is the normal form of the thermodynamics. Maybe we can determine the what is the minus, what is the plus. We define the sign of this. Okay, firstly, electrical inlet, because heat resistance is working, after that the heat is entering the system. Also this this is not also heat because of the electric resistance work, electrical work. Electrical work is plus. Minus Q outlet here. This is the plus, this is the minus. And for this entering the boundary work is expansion. And this is also minus. Okay. Boundary work is expansion. This is also minus because system is gives and the systems use this energy for expansion. Therefore, we use minus is equal to delta U, as you remember. After that, W in and Q out is equal to delta U plus omega V is equal to delta H, as you remember. Delta H is equal to M H2 minus H1. This is the pressure is constant. Electrical inlet we calculated 7.2 kilojoule. Outlet heat is given from the problem is 3.7 kilojoule and is equal to M. M is the given from the problem again, this is the 0.2.5 gram as far as I remember. Maybe we can look again. Pardon. This is another problem. Okay, 25 kilogram. Okay, not 2.5 kilogram, 25 kilogram. 25 kilogram is given for problem and this is 0.025 kilogram. And this is the, we know the H1, this is the H2 and H1, we know the H1 from the table, saturated vapor table, for constant pressure table, of course, table A5. And we calculate the H2 here. Okay. For this H2, we know the pressure because constant pressure process and we know the H2. Also we know the this is the steam. Okay. We know the because of the problem this is the steam because constant pressure this is the superheated region. Therefore we look to superheated region table. Okay. And we look to superheated region table. We look the table again and we determine the what is the temperature of the state 2. Superheated table A6 we look. Table A6. What about the R pressure? Pressure is 300 kilopascal and this is 0.3 megapascal. Am I true or not? Maybe we can define like this. Hmm. 300 kilopascal is like this. 300 multiple pascal. Am I true? And this one, 3 multiple pascal. Therefore, we can set this is 300. This is 0.3 megapascal. Okay. And we said that we looked up table 0.3 megapascal and our pressure is 300. And we looked to what is the H is. We looked to this H. This column is H. Our pressure is here. Our temperature is, pressure is here. We looked to temperature, Our pressure is here. And we looked to temperature. And we looked to H, of course. What is our H? H to 2864.9. Okay. This is 65 dot line as you see here. Therefore, we look to the temperature is so close each other. Temperature is nearly at 200. Maybe we can like here make paint like his. I cut here 200. Okay. Temperature is 200. And nearly maybe it is because in my table, this is the H2. H is here. Okay. Maybe we make format shape. H is here, but this is only one. This is not similar. But in the situation, temperature is 200. Therefore, we set it. Temperature two is nearly 200. Okay. We make maybe interpolation, linear interpolation. We found the 199 centigrees. It is not so important. We can say nearly. Okay. Say that our temperature is nearly 200 centigrees. This problem is good problem because first we use first law of thermodynamics, general form. After that, we look to delta H. After that, we look to delta U. And for the situation, our state is we know the saturated vapor. After that, with constant pressure, our state goes to superheated region. Therefore, this problem contains the chapter 3 and chapter 4. Therefore, this is the really good problem. Also, this, the similar problem is asking from the give the questions for your asking in the midterm exam. Okay, it's also good problem. Now, what about the other one? We solved the other problem because last week I only explained what is this, what is this. Now we solved the problem. Okay, a rigid tank is divided into two equal parts by a partition. Okay, a rigid tank divided into the two equal parts by a partition. Initially, maybe this is the figure here. Initially, one side of the tank contains 5 kilograms worth of water at 200 kilopascal and 25 centigrees, and other side is evacuated. You know that what is evacuated? Evacuated means there is no pressure here. In Turkish, vakumlanmış. Okay, there is no pressure here. Okay, we have 10 minutes. We solved this problem. The partition then, the partition is then removed, and the water expands into the entire tank. The particle is then removed. After that, the water expands into the entire tank. The water is allowed to exchange heat with its surroundings until the temperature in the tank returns initial value 25 centigrade. The water is allowed to exchange heat with surroundings, okay, and until temperature tanks until the initial value. There is no adiabatic system. Of course, they said that the exchange with its surroundings determine the volume of the tank. After that, final pressure. After that, the heat transfer for this process. This is also a good problem, okay? In the situation, what is the volume of the tank? First of all, we calculate the, what is the volume of the tank. They said that this is water at 300 kilopascal and 25 centigrade. Firstly, we look the table. They said that water, I mean that it is compressed liquid, I understand like this, because they said that this is not a water vapor mixture or something like that. But in this situation, I am going to ask really good question now. Please listen carefully. For a compressed liquid region, in this situation, they give the pressure and temperature. But we look the compressed liquid region here. Compressed liquid water, of maybe we can look table A7, or we can look the saturated water. Now I'm going to ask if the problem is a water, and if we have a saturated water and a saturated what saturated water temperature table and a saturated water pressure table. In this situation, which table we look from? Table A4 and table A4, because it gives a temperature to and pressure to. If you look
temperature,
why? This is important. You have to know why. Maybe I can explain like this from the.
Çünkü yayın özellikler sıcaklığa bağlı olarak daha fazla değişiyor.
It's true, maybe it's really true. Maybe where's compressed liquid region? Here, after that, maybe. Compressed liquid region, here. The compressed liquid properties as depend on temperature much more than strongly than the on pressure, okay? Therefore, we look the compressed liquid table, but not compressed liquid table, saturated table, but in the pressure, temperature one, table A4. Okay, we look at table A4. You said right, you said true. And what about the R? Pressure is 25, pardon, temperature 25 centigrade. In the situation, saturated liquid specific volume is 0.001003, okay. And now we look to turn to our problem. Firstly, in this situation, first situation, the volume is origin tank is divided to, and for one side is the water with this properties, other side is evacuated, therefore, for the situation, our volume is half of the tank. We found that. After that, what about the volume of tank? The total volume of tank is like this. Okay, first of all, this is the specific volume. And they said that the 5 kilogram water, 5 kilogram water, therefore we multiply the mass and the specific volume, we get the volume. Volume one, this is the what volume one is, the 0.005 meter cubic, pardon. Okay, meter cubic. And what about the total volume of tank is multiple of 2. Therefore, pardon. And therefore, our tank volume is 0.01 meter cubic. Okay. Therefore, we define the determine the volume of tank. What about the final pressure? Okay. We look to what this is the final pressure. This is the problem showing at the beginning. The properties here. This is the evacuated space. And the Q inlet is here. Okay. And we look the problem again. Q inlet comes here because of the water is allowed to exchange heat is with its surroundings. And the temperature is until the temperature is the 25 centigrade. And firstly, we calculate the final pressure and the what about the heat transfer. First, we calculate the final pressure here. The inlet is come here and the volume is doubled. Okay, in the situation, this is the volume one is here. And this is the volume two, doubled. Okay, volume is doubled. And in the situation, at the final state, we looked at this is the, maybe the final state is defined as a mixture region. After that, we look this. Volume 2 is, specific volume 2 is volume 2 divided by mass. Okay, this is the, we know that. And our total volume is 0.01 meter cubic divided by 5 kilogram. Therefore, our specific volume of the state 2 is 0.002 meter cubic divided by kilogram. Okay. They said that the state 2 is 25 centigrade. Because in this situation, they said that 25 centigrade, maybe we can look again. The initial value, the surroundings until the temperature in the tank returns initial value of 25 centigrade. Okay. Now we look to table again. The same table, temperature table, 25 centigrade. Okay. Here. We look here. Therefore, we look the saturated liquid specific volume we looked at. After that, our look to our specific volume of state 2 is like this. As you know, that's 0.002 meter cubic divided by kilogram. Therefore, I make a print screen again. Okay. This one. And I'm copy here and make this copy is important. Therefore, in the situation, state 2 is specific volume is here. From the here, 0.002. Okay. Therefore, this problem is because of this vapor side, this is the gas side. Therefore, this state 2 is related to vapor mixture because of the our specific volume is between the specific volume of fluid and specific volume of gas. Okay. Therefore, our situation is, you see the here, our situation is liquid and vapor mixture region. First, we define of this. After that, what about the final pressure of state 2? Therefore, we looked at what about the final pressure. The final pressure is here. The saturated temperature is 25 centigrade and our the final pressure is, as you know, that 3.1698. Our final pressure is like this. Okay. After that, 10 minutes later, we will continue this problem and we'll continue the next subjects. Okay. See you in next 10 minutes.